freshman of Fox Creek High School. I'm your contestant number 3, Anna Lee Grace Lutzer. Hi Fox Creek, I'm contestant number 4, Taylor Bree Lyons.
Welcome to the home of the Predators. I'm Madison Thatcher, your contestant number 5.
Representing the sophomore class, I'm Shelby Grace Benson, your contestant number 6. Good evening and thank you for coming. I'm contestant number 7, Julianne Guest.
Thank you. Heather Widener, and members of the PTCA. We'd also like to say thank you to our judges, certainly our score tabulator, Cindy Smith, vocalist Shelly McGee, who will provide us with the entertainment later this evening.
We would also like to ask you to please use the doors in the back of the gym and the restrooms in the promenade to avoid any distractions up front. Let's begin with our casual wear. Starting with freshman contestant number one. Contestant number one, Gabby Davis, daughter of Ann and Chris Wilson and Roger Davis. She does volunteer work for her church, along with babysitting. She is specially trained in the clarinet and cheerleading. Gabby enjoys water skiing, kneeboarding, snowboarding, and attending church. In the future, she would like to become a nurse. She looks forward to weekly family dinner night with her family. And she would also like to travel and explore the world to learn new things. She is a member of student council and achieves straight A's and perfect attendance. Thank you, contestant number one, Gabby Davis. Contestant number two, Taylor Elizabeth Jones, daughter of Cindy and Tim Jones. She is on the A&E honor roll, loves riding four-wheelers, hunting, fishing, and shopping with her mom. She also enjoys spending time with family and friends. In the future, she would like to pursue a career in the medical field. In her free time, she babysits her family and friends around North Augusta. Thank you, contestant number two, Taylor Jones. Contestant number three, Annalie Grace Leppard, daughter of Gordon and Jill Leppard. Annalie is in cross country and attends youth group every Wednesday night. She loves to sing, draw, paint, sew, look at the sky, talk with her friends and family and her teachers, play with her cousins, run, read, and organize things. Her future ambition is to become an astronaut. Thank you, Annalie Leppard, contestant number three. Contestant number four, Taylor Bree Lyons. She is the daughter of Charity and Tyler Lyons. She is in competitive cheerleading and attends Sweetwater Baptist Church on Sundays and Wednesdays. She's volunteered with the cheer squad at A Night to Shine. And her hobbies include looking through Pinterest for future house plans and decor, and she loves her cat, Grace, who is her best friend. In the future, she would like to become a cosmetologist, working with different hairstyles and nails. Thank you, contestant number four, Taylor Lyons. Contestant number five, Madison Thatcher. Daughter of Sarah Thatcher and Mark Jones. She enjoys volunteering through the children's ministry program at church. In the future, she hopes to attend Augusta State University to become a nurse and work at MCG Children's Hospital with cancer patients. She likes to vlog, participate in cheerleading, and watch Grey's Anatomy. In 2020, she won the award of Palmetto's Finest Vlogger. Thank you, contestant number 5. Freshmen, please step forward for collective judges. Thank you, freshman contestants.
Moving on to our sophomore girls, contestant number 6, Shelby Grace Benson. Shelby is the daughter of Chris and April Benson. Her future ambition is to attend the University of South Carolina, Columbia with a degree in pre-med and become a pediatric surgeon. Her hobbies include animals and interior design. Shelby's activities are varsity softball, junior varsity volleyball. Shelby's award have been the most offensive player, and she won Miss Freshman last year. Thank you, contestant number 6, Shelby Grace Benson. Sophomore contestant number 7, Juliana Carol Guest. Juliana is the daughter of Norman and Stephanie Guest. Her future ambition is to go to medical school and become a trauma surgeon. Her hobbies and interests include running, making crafts, reading, journaling, playing viola, dancing, hiking, and also studying. Juliana's activities is the Fox Creek Yearbook and Aiken Youth Orchestra. Thank you, contestant number 7, Juliana Carol Guest. Sophomore contestant number 8, Jenna McKay Williamson. Jenna's the daughter of Luke and Linda Williamson. Her future ambition is to attend USCA, become a teacher, get married, and start a family. Her hobbies and interests include tumbling, surfing, cheering, drama, social. She enjoys working. Her activities include the Chamber of Commerce, Junior Leadership Academy, National Honor Society. Thank you, contestant number 8, Jenna McKay Williams. Sophomore contestants, please step forward for collective judging. Please take a half turn to the back. And to the front. Thank you, sophomore girls.
On juniors, starting with contestant number 9, KK Griffiths. the daughter of Daryl and Ewan Griffiths. KK is specially trained and self-taught in acrobatic tumbling, playing the piano, soccer, sewing, and crafting with her Cricut machine. She is also knowledgeable in digital media and growing a sustainable garden. Her ambition is to launch an eco-friendly skincare line for patients with all skin types. She would also like to attend the Medical University of South Carolina to pursue a career in dermatology. Thank you, KK. Contestant number 10, Alexis Trinity Moore. Daughter of Sarah and Jimmy Rooney and James and Jamie Moore. Alexis helps prepare meals for a local homeless resource center. She is a volunteer in the church nursery and is also the church nursery coordinator. Alexis enjoys spending time with her best friend and her family, baking with her mama, and taking an occasional nap. Alexis wants to become a cosmetologist and earn a degree in business management to one day open her own salon. Thank you, Alexis. Contestant number 11, Melody K. Schluter, daughter of Aldine and Josh Caffey. She received a varsity letter award for competitive cheerleading, is specially trained in flexibility, tumbling, and singing. She enjoys reading, skateboarding, doing makeup, hanging out with her friends, and creating artwork. Her future ambition is to become a heart surgeon. Thank you, Melody. Contestant number 12, Kinley McCarson Widener. She's the daughter of Michael and Heather Widener. She is specially trained in assisting doctors and nurses in the cardiac ICU while volunteering. Her goal is to attend the University of Mississippi and become a registered nurse with a minor in business and further her career as in pharmaceutical sales rep, specializing in orthopedics. Upon graduation, she would like to marry a doctor and or a cowboy and own a cattle farm. But most importantly, she wants to own baby cows.
Baby cows.
Her hobbies include playing softball, cheerleading, and tennis. Going to rodeos and music concerts with her family, and fishing from her kayak. She is also trained in skeet shooting and spending her daddy's money. Thank you, Kinley. Junior girls, please step forward for collective judging. And to the front. Thank you, junior contestants.
McKenna is the daughter of Daryl and Ewan Griffiths. Her hobbies and interests include being a food connoisseur, finding deals and steals on clothes,
performing in plays, going on picnics, and singing along to country music. McKenna's awards include being the current senior class salutatorian, West Point Award, and Distinguished Young Woman of North Edgefield County. McKenna volunteers with Children with Special Needs and the Leukemia and Lymphoma Society. Thank you, contestant number 13, McKenna Ewan Griffiths. Senior contestant number 14, Annabeth Lepa. Annabeth is the daughter of Greg and Sherry Leppard. She plans to become an oncologist to work with special needs children in the medical field. Her hobbies and academics are reading mostly anything, experimenting with makeup, and shopping. Annabeth's awards is Honor Society, as well as Beta Club, and recently being granted an academic scholarship to Clemson University. Annabeth's activities include Student Council, Beta Club, National Honor Society. She's an honors graduate. A varsity cheerleader. Annabeth volunteers for the Special Olympics, Night to Shine, Operation Christmas Child, as well as the 5K Color Run to support epilepsy. Annabeth is specially trained in FCA leadership and competitive cheerleading. Thank you, contestant number 14, Annabeth Lever. Senior contestant number 15, Natalie Jane Nordine. Natalie is the daughter of Skip and Tina Nordine. Hey. Her ambition is to be an elementary school teacher while continuing to run her own business, Natalie Natural Memories. Natalie's awards is the Fox Creek High School Class of 2021 Student of the Year, Most School Spirit Senior Superlative, Palmetto Girls State Representative, and Distinguished Young Woman of South Edgefield County. Now that Natalie volunteers with the Leukemia and Lymphoma Society Student of the Year fundraiser, as well as Special Olympics volunteer, American Red Cross, and American Heart Association. Natalie's activities include competition cheer, yearbook editor, senior advisory Beta Club, as well as National Honor Society. Thank you, contestant number 15, Natalie Jane Nordine. Our contestant number 16, Abby Elizabeth Thomas. Abby is the daughter of Ben and Lisa Thomas. Her future ambition is to become a pediatric trauma nurse. Her hobbies and interests are babysitting Grace and Griffin, working, spending time with family and friends. Her awards, Student Ambassador of the Year. She has received a full scholarship to Charleston Southern University. Junior and Senior Advisor. Thank you, contestant number 16, Abby Elizabeth Thomas. Senior contestants, please step forward for collective judging.
Gabriella Kenna Davis.
Jones.
contestant number three, Anna Lee Grace Leppard.
I see it in your eyes, you can feel it from my heart. From here on after, let's stay the way we are right now, and share all the love and laughter that a lifetime will allow.
Contestant number four, Taylor Bree Lyons. Freshman contestants, please return to the stage for collective judging.
Her day starts with a coffee, ends with a contest for every
half turn to the back.
Look in her eyes. Well, it kind of scares me the way that she drives me wild. She drives
into
me
into the front.
Number six, Shelby Grace Benson.
Cause it changes and makes it let's stay on the couch and watch TV. And she falls asleep.
Seems so old now looking back. Thank you, South Hill contestants. All right, on to our junior girls. Contestant number 9. KK Melissa Griffiths. Thank you, KK. Contestant number 10, Alexis Trinity Moore.
I was a boat stuck in a bottle, but never got the chance to touch the sea. Just forgot on the ship, no wind in the sails, going nowhere with no one. I was 1 in 100 billion, a burnout star in a galaxy. Just lost in the sky, wondering why everyone else shines out for me. But I can't get life from my first kiss to you. Best me, had his arms around you.
Thank you, number 10, Alexis Trinity. Contestant number 11, Melody K. Schluter. Thank you, Melody. Contestant number 12, Kingley McCarson Wagner.
Thank you.
all. I've been around, I've been lost, and I've been found. But who I
Junior contestants, please return to the stage for collective judging.
Moving on to our seniors, starting with contestant number 13, McKenna Ewan Griffiths.
P. Johnson on a flat bottom metal boat. Coke cans and BB guns on wiring old fence posts. 8-point bucks in autumn and fresh.
Thank you, contestant number 13, McKenna Ewan Griffin.
Sunday drives in town with you. What's the point of this old guitar? It ain't got no strings. Pouring your heart into a song that you ain't gonna sing. It's a match made up in heaven, like good old boys and beer and me, as long as you're right here. Your license in my wallet when we go out downtown. Your lipstick stained every coffee cup that I got in this house. The way you sing I love you too is like rain on an old tin roof. And your hand fits right into mine like a needle in a groove. Some things just go better together. And probably always will, like a cup of coffee and a sunrise. Sunday drives and time to kill. What's the point of this old guitar if it ain't got no strings? Or pouring your heart into a song that you ain't gonna sing. It's a match made up in heaven, like good old boys and beer. And me. Sometimes we oil and water, but I wouldn't have it any other way. And if I'm being honest, your first to my last name would just sound better together, and probably always will, like a cup of coffee and a sunrise. Sunday drives and time to kill. What's the point of this old guitar if it ain't got no strings? Or pouring your heart into a song that you ain't gonna sing. It's a match made up in heaven.
Thank you, contestant number 14, Hannah Elizabeth Leppard. Senior contestant number 15, Natalie Jane Nordine.
the judges.
Where is your favorite place that you have been?
My favorite place I have been is Lake Jackson because of the beautiful clear water and the beautiful waterfalls and the amazing mountain background. Thank you.
What makes you the happiest?
What makes me the happiest would have to be spending time with my family and friends. I really value them and I love spending time with them so much. Thank you.
What is your least favorite chore you have to do at home and why?
My least favorite chore to do at home is washing the dishes because I don't like the smell of the food on the plates mixed with the water, but I still do it when I'm asked, or even when I'm not asked, because I believe it's helping out my parents and helping our home flow steadily.
What three items would you bring with you to a deserted island and why?
If I had to bring three items to a deserted island, it would have to be one, a machete for protection, two, a fire starter to be able to cook food and boil water, and then three would have to be a friend or animal of my choice to keep me company.
What is your idea of success?
My idea of success is graduating high school and to move on to college to be a pediatric nurse to help children. Thank you.
Thank you, freshman contestants. Let's bring out our sophomore girls.
Thank you.
What is the hardest thing about being a student? What is the hardest thing about being a student?
The hardest thing about being a student is definitely being a student athlete. Trying to struggle to keep my grades up and struggling to be the best that I can on the field is definitely very hard, but I try to succeed in every way I can. Thank you.
Who, other than your mom, is your role model? Who, other than your mom, is your role model?
Other than my mom, I would have to say my role model is a lady I met at church. She is a pediatrician, she is a general surgeon, and she has a husband and 3 children. She is able to balance the work of being a surgeon and the full-time career of being a mother and a wife at the same time. I hope one day I'm able to balance my career and my family life just like her. Thank you.
What is one thing that motivates you? What is one thing that motivates you?
One thing that motivates me is getting into my dream college and pursuing my dream career. The reason this motivates me is because I want to do good for my parents, and I want them to see that I am the girl that they taught me to be.
Thank you.
Thank you, sophomore contestants. Let's bring out the juniors. Where do you see yourself in the next 5 to 10 years?
In the next 5 to 10 years, I see myself attending College of Charleston, planning to be a heart surgeon, and going to MUSC as my medical school.
What has been a challenge you have experienced in your life, and how did you overcome it?
Well, at an early age, I was diagnosed with autism. Also, I was born with oxygen deprivation, which led me to miss a part. It made me miss part of my frontal lobe, and I can't. It's really hard for me to talk about. I'm sorry. I can't function simple numbers, but with my amazing IEP teacher, I've been able to overcome that. So I really think that's the biggest thing for me.
Thank you.
Thank you, junior contestants. All right, senior contestants.
Benefited or hurt our ability to form personal relationships? Again, has technology benefited or hurt our ability to form personal relationships?
More than ever, especially in these unprecedented times, I definitely believe that technology is our best friend
and has been able to be a powerful tool that we can use to transform personal relationships. Like I said earlier, COVID-19 has brought us many devastations. One in particular is virtual learning. Without virtual learning and the platform of technology, I would not be able to conglomerate and to be an efficient student throughout the school. Second, without technology, I wouldn't have been able to meet my college future roommate. So thank you to Instagram for that, for allowing me to meet her and for her to inspire me to continue my passion for medical advancements. And third, I know we all love TikTok, and as a TikTok user, I believe that this also is a positive platform. I'm able to look at other users, see their life journey, and respect them for their life journey. And third, on TikTok, I can see my favorite cooking videos, and it pushes me to be a better chef. So through all of these amazing opportunities, I'm able to grow personal relationships through the use of technology.
What is a challenge you have overcome in your life? Once again, what is a challenge you have overcome in your life?
A challenge I have overcome in my life is bullying. Throughout middle school, I was a victim of bullying, and the way that I overcame this was to remind myself every day that I am made in a perfect image and that what other people say doesn't matter as long as I have confidence and believe in myself.
Define what the word classy means to you. Again, define what the word classy means to you.
When I hear the word classy, the first thing that comes to my mind is my mama, who's sitting right back there. In August, we lost my pathball, and it was something that was so tremendously hard because of the COVID-19. We weren't able to be with her or my grandfather while they were dealing with that. So she has dealt with this with strength, courage, and passion every single day, and I admire her so much for that. She is an icon in this community because of things that she has done for children in our youth center, as well as our family. She loves us so good, and she also has the best cooking. So if I could define the word classy, look right back there to my grandma. That lady is 120% one of the most amazing people you will ever meet in your whole life, and she is the definition of class.
What is the biggest change you would like to see in young women of the next generation? Again, what is the biggest change you would like to see in young women of the next generation?
The biggest change that I want to see in the next generation of women is women supporting other women. In today's society, social media has given you a standard that they expect you to be, and it is very unrealistic. Today, females degrade each other and do not support one another, and that makes being a confident young woman extremely hard. And in the next generation, I pray that our women learn to support each other, and that no matter what size you are beautiful and confident in each and every possible way.
So many of us. It has been a year of difficulties as well as personal development. Although this year has been challenging, I am honored to have been given the opportunity to represent Fox Creek High School as Miss Senior. I'd like to thank the directors of the Miss Fox Creek pageant and all those who volunteered their time to make this an amazing experience. Secondly, I would like to thank my family for their continued support and encouragement, not only throughout the pageant, but also throughout my first year at college. I am so blessed with family and friends who love and support me. Finally, thank you to Fox Creek High School for so many memories. I'm proud to have represented you. For the last time, I am Sarah Massey, Miss Fox Creek Senior, 2020.
And our reigning queen, Miss Tori Jackson.
The Fox Creek pageant is one of the major reasons I'm the woman who stands on this stage today. Throughout my 4 years of doing this pageant, not only have I had the privilege of meeting these wonderful ladies, but I got to see each and every one of them grow and mature throughout their high school experience. Some of my favorite memories at Fox Creek High School were made behind the stage with these beautiful ladies, whether it was running to get changed before evening wear or holding a prayer circle before crowning. This pageant wasn't the only thing that made me who I am today. I've been blessed with incredibly supportive parents, a mom who is my biggest cheerleader, and who will always pick me back up and remind me why I started something when I get discouraged. A dad who comes up with catchy slogans for my introductions and has the best eye for dresses and jewelry to go with them. I was blessed to have a sister to show me what it means to be a confident woman and a role model to those around her. I'm blessed to have amazing grandparents who come to cheer me on every chance they get. To Uncle David, Aunt Valerie, and of course Liz, thank you so much for how much you've invested in me. Between years of doing my hair and makeup, always having the perfect gowns for me, the countless hours of training and the encouragement that you've always given me to constantly grow and improve myself, I'll forever be grateful to you. Thank you to the fantastic women who run this pageant. Your hard work and dedication has not been unseen, and without you, none of this could happen. Thank you, Ms. Davis, for the years of mentorship. Not only have you taught me how to be a better artist, but you've also taught me how to be a better woman. Some of the best advice that I hold near and dear to my heart was given in that art room over whatever painting I was making too smooth at the time. I'm eternally grateful for your love and support and the many opportunities you have given me. And finally, thank you to the amazing staff and administration of Fox Creek High School for always being there for me when I needed it and for constantly making improvements to better the education and lives of the students here. To the ladies waiting backstage behind me, I encourage you to take a deep breath. I know the feeling of adrenaline going through your veins and your heart beating out of your chest waiting for that crowning moment, but I can confidently say that the most rewarding parts of this experience are the moments that the audience doesn't see. The effort put into picking out the most gorgeous wardrobe that makes you feel like queen of the world. The hours of practicing with your mom, sister, or again tonight with you. So take a deep breath, give the girl next to you a hug, and be proud of yourselves and all the effort that you put into tonight. To the new Miss Fox Creek, I hope your reign is filled with joy and pride in this school. I hope that even in this new world that we have adjusted to, that you find a way to be an inspiration and role model to those around you. Never overlook an opportunity to encourage those who need it, and be willing to step into the leadership role whenever you are needed for support or advice. Whether or not you leave with a crown tonight, I see the courage it takes for you to get on this stage, and I am proud of you. I'm Victoria Nicole Jackson, signing off as your Miss Fox Creek High School 2020.
He was sitting there. from a bag at my side. Picked up a brush and said to me, I'm just wearing this picture.
Photogenic, Kinley Widener. This year's Miss Congeniality, McKenna Griffiths. Our People's Choice Award, Miss Jenna Williamson. And our most ad sales, Madison Thatcher. Contestant number two. Shelby Benson. Your 2021 Miss Sophomore, number 8, Jenna Williamson. juniors. Miss Junior, first runner-up, number 12, Kinley Widener. Your Miss Junior, number 9, KK Perfect. Our highest GPA award goes to McKenna Griffiths. Our second runner-up, number 16, Abby Thomas. Runner-up, number 13, McKenna Griffiths. Your Miss Senior, number 14, Anna Beth Leppard. And your 2021 Miss Fox Creek High School, number 15, Natalie Nordine. Take those, just don't come on the stage yet.